Hi there, my name is Tom Crindle from Gear Mashers, and today we're taking a look at the Apple TV 4K and Zwift and connection issues that people might have when they're trying to set up their smart trainer using the Apple TV 4K and Zwift. So the way it works is the Apple TV 4K has three Bluetooth slots that you can connect Bluetooth devices. The first slot is used actually with the controller here, so you can't use that. And then the other two slots are for other Bluetooth devices like a heart rate monitor that I have on here, a cadence sensor that you might have on your bike, and then the power or watt meter or something like that. So with Zwift, let me just click on here, and I ride on Zwift as gearmashers.com. So when you load up the Zwift application, it's going to be looking for a power source or a speed sensor, one of the two. And so what you're going to want to do is you're going to want to connect your trainer or turn your trainer on. And so I'm going to turn my trainer on here. And over in the left-hand side, what it's saying is it's running the Zwift companion app to find devices. Well, I don't want to have it set up like that. I want to use the Apple TV initially. And so I'm going to click on this. And so now it's using the Apple TV to try to locate all my Bluetooth devices. And so it found my heart rate monitor. And so that shows up over here. And then it found the power source, which is my trainer, which also controls the trainer. So these two lit up. And then I have my cadence sensor. And normally, like with a cadence, you might have to start pedaling just to activate it to make sure that it's active. And then you can go down into your cadence and turn that on. Now, when I do this, what I should see is an error message pop up saying I'm trying to connect too many devices to Apple TV. And so the reason for that is because I have my trainer. And so that's one connection in the Apple TV. I have my heart rate monitor, so that's the second one. So right now the Apple TV is all booked up because it has the controller for one slot, the trainer for one slot, and my heart rate monitor. So when I click on cadence here, I find my cadence, and so then I get the error message, too many Bluetooth devices trying to connect to your Apple TV. And so to get around this issue, we're going to be using the Zwift companion app, and what that will allow me to do is connect additional Bluetooth devices so that I get beyond the limitation of the Apple TV. So over here where it says Apple TV is out of Bluetooth connections, would you like to try to connect through Zwift? I'm going to hit yes. And now what you're supposed to do is you're going to load up your companion app. And so you can download this from the App Store. It's the Zwift companion app. Or if you have a different phone besides Apple, you download it from whatever store you need to. And when the companion app loads, what we're looking for here is for the map to show up. And once the map shows up, then we're all ready and we'll be able to see a little icon here. So currently today, Zwift's running in London. So I see a little map for London here. And on the left-hand side now, I see a little Bluetooth signal coming from my Zwift companion app. If you don't see that, one of the things you may have to do is you click on more down at the very bottom, and you wanna go into the settings for the Zwift companion app, and you're gonna wanna go into device connection. And you want to make sure that your device connection is turned on. And so I have that turned on. And so now the last thing you want to do is you want to go into your cadence, since it says no signal here, and you just want to click it. That's going to deactivate that. And now you want to tap to pair. And this time the cadence sensor is going to pair with the companion app rather than through the Apple TV, because if it tried to go through the Apple TV, we'd get that error message again. So I'm gonna click on that. And so here's my cadence sensor up there. So everything's good to go. So I have my two connections, my power source and my heart rate, those are going through the Apple TV, and then my cadence sensor is going through the companion app. And so now, hopefully, I'm gonna get on the bike, and if I did everything correctly, everything should show up within Zwift. So I'm just gonna click on ride here, just do a free ride. So I'm just gonna jump on my bike and start pedaling. And so my watts start showing up and my RPMs are showing and also my heart rate. So everything's good. So I have all the values in the left-hand side that I wanna see when I'm riding in Zwift. And we're pretty much good to go. So that's how you do it. I spent a few days trying to figure this all out and how everything works. And it was because of the Apple TV and the two slots or the two slots that allowed you to connect, but not allowing you to connect three devices. That was the issue. And you have to sort of go through this process and to get everything set up. Please hit the subscribe button. That helps me get products in like these and do talks like this. Also, check out gearmasters.com. I'll have a full write-up on what I just talked about. And hopefully, if you have any issues, just leave them in the comments and I'll try to answer them. Maybe someone else that's seen the video will try to answer as well. Thank you so much for watching and have a great day.